Encounters with Griefers Part 2. Welcome and thanks for watching. This clip's going to be a little different than the first Encounters with Griefers in a sense that that was a compilation of a bunch of people. The other day I had a friend in the U.S. and, I've been sending some invites to them to my lobby because people have been having problems with NPCs, strange emissions, animals not spawning. So from time to time I go ahead and send friends an invite. I specifically told him I had other things to do. I would jump on for about a minute, send him an invite. Once he got in, I was going to go ahead and take off. He didn't reply back for a couple minutes, so I was just sitting around waiting. And then I noticed two people were approaching me, and then that's basically where this takes place here. So I've seen this trick so many times. Somebody comes up, you know, out of nowhere, tries to get you to wave at them, and then they pull out a gun and shoot you. Or in this case, you know, this isn't the first time that I've seen this trick. One person comes up, kind of distracts you while somebody else comes up and tries to kill you or takes aim. So that's what these two clowns have going on. And you'll end up seeing in this clip, they only end up killing me one time. I think I probably killed them a total of 40 to 50 times. Probably let's just say 40 times. It took place at two different parts of the map. And you'll see here, I didn't kill the other person because who knows, they're in a posse. Maybe one person was just coming to see what was up. And then the other person just got a little trigger happy. So I could have gone ahead and taken out the posse leader, but I give people the benefit of the doubt. You know, I usually never shoot at people unless they shoot at me first, or it's really clear that they're pulling out a gun with the intentions to try to shoot me. So that's why I'm waiting for this posse leader to go ahead and pull out a gun. I could have gone ahead and blasted that one, you know, anytime in this clip. But you saw that one just creeped up over the rock and started taking another shot. So they are a little bit lower than me as far as level, so I'm trying to go ahead and kill them. And like I said, I really wasn't in the mood to go ahead and get into a battle. I literally jumped on for about a minute to send an invite. Once my friend got on, I was going to take off and go do some other things. But once this happened, you know, there's no way in hell I'm going to go ahead and leave and give these two the satisfaction of saying, oh, we got him to leave the session or we messed with this game. So I've been in some battles before for hours because of that fact. I won't parlay with people if I'm getting my ass kicked. And even if I don't feel like fighting, I'll keep going until the other person leaves. I'm not going to go ahead and, like I said, give them the satisfaction of like, oh, we got him to leave. Even though my intention is to get the hell out of here because I do have other stuff to do. Unfortunately, my friend ended up logging off, so he never ended up even joining the session. So it was kind of pointless for me to jump on. These two little battles here ended up lasting, I would say, roughly about a total of, I'd say, 40 to 45 minutes. I did not record every single clip because I do have some other projects that I'm working on and my Xbox storage is full. So I kind of just ended up, you know, every once in a while recording some clips. For the beginning here, I'm not going to edit out too much. I want to go ahead and show you, you know, exactly how the situation's played out. Later on, I will go ahead and do some editing just to kind of give the kills. But what ends up happening is here, I end up killing these guys numerous times. Pretty soon coming up, I end up running into an ambush. My horse, I think, gets shot, jumps off a damn cliff into the river. And then these two still keep approaching me. So every time I kill them, I end up moving usually about a couple hundred yards to see if they're going to go ahead and give chase. If they do, then I'm going to go ahead and target them as soon as they come up. That's why you'll see from time to time their icons are bright red, and sometimes they are back to pink, meaning there's been some time in between the attacks or the gunfights. So after we end up battling over here for a little bit, I end up noticing that they kind of had enough. They took off. I think they went to an ammo shop or a store at some station. Ended up refilling on this stuff, so I ended up going ahead up to Cumberland Forest to do some ambushes and some hideouts. And then I notice that these guys are taking the trek all the way across from like the north part of Strawberry over to Valentine or Cumberland Forest. So I just kind of sat there, got ready, waited for them. And then, phase two of the battle ended up, taking place. So I'm not going to go ahead and commentate my fault over this whole entire video. But what ends up happening at Cumberland Forest is, you know, I end up killing them numerous times. And I think the total was probably about, I'd say, let's just give it a low estimate of 40 kills between the two of them. They killed me one time, and I don't know what the hell happened. I was on my horse, my shotgun for some reason wasn't landing. But regardless, it was funny as hell. You can see in the clip, it was like I was a trophy after they finally killed me after all these times of getting their asses kicked. One of them ends up carrying my body off, like I said, like it's a damn trophy. I ended up switching to my high velocity, ended up taking him out. And then there's a couple more kills after that, and then you see in the end of the clip, that both of them end up leaving the session, which was basically my plan. I was not going to leave first. There's no way in hell that was going to happen. Once I noticed they were basically done and had enough in this first round, and they ended up taking off, I kind of didn't chase them. I kind of went and did my own thing. Figured I could go ahead and find some treasure maps or something like that, get some more XP to level up. And that's why I ended up going to Cumberland Forest. Also ended up getting some pig fat or some animal fat from the pig farm over there in Valentine. And, you know, then phase two took place. That lasted for a while. I did not record all the clips. As it was, I probably had about 20 to 25 minutes worth of clips. I ended up narrowing it down, all the little slow times in between. Sometimes I killed them and they spawned way the hell away from me, so I kind of had to wait for them to come pursue me before the battle started again. So I'm going to go ahead and upload this video. Hopefully by the time this gets uploaded to YouTube, the new updates of Red Dead will be out. I will be doing a bunch of videos to cover the new weapons, the new game modes, and some other stuff as far as the regular free roam missions, and also this new parlay system and the new radar blips for people griefing and possibly some of the bounties and some of the deterrents for people who are griefing to try to, you know, Rockstar's attempt to try to get them to stop. So hopefully we'll have some great information coming out, some great updates that'll really help the game, make things a little bit more interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and take off now, let this play out. Definitely appreciate the support for you, from you guys on my channel, especially over the past month. I think I've had over 550 subscribers just in the past 28 days. Big shout out to all of you. I really appreciate that. I just ended up getting over the 2,000 subscriber mark. So again, you know, it's a big milestone. It's been a long time coming, and I definitely can't stress enough how much I appreciate it. So look forward to some more videos later today. Enjoy the rest of this clip, and I will see you guys next time.